morning, we ask you to sit vigil, to listen to the words of the populace and the business order. Now you come before us, and we ask you this question. Will you accept the noble order of the Laurel from our hands instead? We are very well pleased with that. Thank you. There are those that would like to say some words. And at this point, we ask those individuals to please stand. Great preparation. What say our members of the chivalry?
Your Majesties, I would speak for Lady Thoros. Peers should be leaders. They should be inspirational. They should be examples of the virtues we all hold dear. For years, Emengar has walked the path to seek knowledge of these virtues. In the course of her journey, she has emerged to become an example to me and to others of the understanding that each of us is imperfect, that we should all seek to improve ourselves so that we might be seen as examples worthy of emulation. She has demonstrated more clearly than most knowledge that this is in fact a journey, not a destination. I will continue to look forward to her as an inspiration, and I recommend her to you.
Thank you.
Your Majesties, there is. For those of you who do not know me, I am Duchess Avelina, and it is my honor to speak to Emengar this day. Your Majesties, I can tell you the day that I met Emengar. It was at the investiture of Fergus and Amelia of Carolingia. Emengar had come forward to present gifts to the outgoing baron. And I remember this bundle of brown string came out, and she said, Your Excellency, I have made you a hair net. And I thought, wow, I've got a lot of hair. And it's a hair net. And then I got to know Emengar, and I learned of her passion for teaching and her joy in sharing all of that. She is a wonderful, wonderful peer and an asset to our kingdom, and she will lead us with comportment and courtesy, and I am so pleased to commend her to you.
Thank you. Let's say our masters of defense.
I am Natallia, master of defense. Teaching and building a community is near and dear to my heart and a focus of the masters of defense. Everyone I spoke to about you, everyone, spoke of your love, your passion for teaching, that you would teach anyone everything you know. This is a grand thing. I encourage you to continue because your community is right here. And I commend you to their majesties this day.
Thank you for your words.
I am a member of the Order of the Pelican that will speak for this lady.
I am Peter the Red. I will speak for Emengar, or she's commonly known to us as Birka. I have known Emengar for 7-ish years, and I have known she has a wonderful talent, especially for the finer arts. And I have not yet seen her spin straw into gold, but I have seen her go from a sheep to a shawl. I have seen her spin my darling's fur into thread. So gold is yet to come. So as a pelican, I should speak to her service. And what better way to give service to the Kingdom of the East than to spread that talent and teach it. And she does that a lot. I have seen her teaching spinning, scrying, null, bending, kumi imo, and hairnets. That's what the big rabbits. She's been seneschal for the Hand of the Towers for over 4 years, and organized the craft evenings that we do and project days. And I would like to say I had a conversation with her not too long ago, well, quite a while ago actually, and it was when I was bringing on proteges as I am a pelican, and we had this conversation together, and she kind of wanted to be my protege, and I said, no, I'm sorry, you are my peer, and you have been my peer since I have met you. You are wonderful, I commend it to you.
Thank you for these words.
Thank you.
And finally, what says our royal law?
Your Majesties, I'm Johanna Dudley. I, Emengar's research and skills have woven a strong fabric of knowledge throughout your kingdom. Her work looms large into your neighbors and your dyers. She combs through research and casts her net of knowledge.
To all who seek to learn, I recommend Emengar to you with every fiber of my being.
Take care of it.